Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this tutorial, we will see what is the need for the code generation. And in the previous tutorial, we have seen what is a V model actually, and what are the different stages in a V model. Now, to see the previous video, you can check that video and then see this one. So what is the need of code generation? Why, at the first step, we need the code generation. Suppose there is a developer who is writing the C code and he is fixing all these errors that he thinks could be a possible bug and developing the C code for a production software. There is another team who is developing the same thing in the form of a model-based development. They are using MATLAB Simulink toolchain and then they are developing the same behavior, which could be a graphical programming environment. This is the entire development process that the two teams are doing. So this is team one and this is team two. Now the software is being verified by a tester or a verification team. Now they found that there is a bug in the software or there could be a change in the requirement which the owner of the software wants to implement. These are the two possible cases where there is a requirement of change in the software. Now this change is being communicated to the two teams and both are being given with a deadline. So when it comes to the hand-coded C programmer, he need to see the code in the text format and then he need to do the implementation or the changes, which may take a longer time. So it may take longer time and it is not sure like all the errors the change is requesting or the bug is requesting will be fixed on time, and also it will be very hard to debug it or to fix all those things within time, because this is related to a text-based coding implementation. Coming to team 2, when they are trying to implement the change, they will do it in a graphical way, which is more human interpretable. So in this case, they will be using Simulink, they will be doing the update, and automatically they are generating the C code. And as the environment is offering a graphical user interface, they will be also able to verify at two stages. One is the mill stage and another is the sill stage. The mill stage implements the verification in the model and the sill stage implements the verification in the code. That way they can ensure a bug-free software, and this will be done within a short amount of time because the generation of code is done automatically from MATLAB. So whenever there is a change request or any bug that is being reported, it is the most preferable way to go for a model-based development approach compared to a hand code approach. In case you are liking our channel, please consider subscribing to the channel and stay updated to our latest videos. Happy learning MATLAB, and we will see the next concept in the next tutorial. Have a good day. Thank you.